First, we have to select a new assembly design. Unclick the use default template edits. Then click OK. Select the unit millimeter newton seconds assembly design. Then click OK. First, we have to insert the component which we already created. So select a corresponding component by browsing it and click open and place it at the required positions. Apply the constraint as a fix, then click OK. Again, we have to insert some more component. Go to the assembly, browse our component, click open and move to the corresponding direction by dragging the triad. Then we have to go to placement, apply the constraints based upon your requirement. First, we have to apply the parallel constraints. Select a corresponding planes for apply the parallel constraints. Then create a new constraint type. Then select a two planes for apply the coincident. Again, we have to create a new constraint. Select the both top faces of the shaft for apply the coincident. At last, we have to give a one more constraint. Select a offset distance between the two planes. Give the corresponding distance based upon your requirement between the two planes. Then click OK. After that, we have to insert the gears. Go to the assembly, click assemble, select our corresponding gear, click open, place it at the required positions. Here we have to apply the user defined pin type constraints. Select user defined, and inside them we have to select a pin joint. Select a pin and select a two corresponding center axis. Then we have to go to placement, apply the coincident between the two parallel faces. Now the connection definition is successfully complete. Then click OK. Again, we have to insert a one more gear. So go to the assembly, quick assemble, select a corresponding gear part and click open and place it at a required position. Just click show triad and move it for the required location. After that, we have to just hide the triad. Then go to the user defined, click the pin type joint. Select the two corresponding center axes. Then we have to apply the coincident. Go to the placement. Select the two corresponding top faces of gear and a shaft. Now the connection definition is successfully complete. Just click OK. Then we have to drag the components. The motion cannot be transmitted to the another gear, so we have to apply the mechanisms. Go to the applications, select the mechanism. Inside the mechanism, we have to select a gear type mechanism. In a gear 1, we have to select a motion axis. First, we have to select a gear 1 and select a corresponding axis of the gear for apply the mate. Then we have to specify the pitch circle diameter of a gear. Then we have go for gear 2, select a gear 2 and click the corresponding center motion axis. Then we have to specify the pitch circle diameter. After specifying the diameter, just click apply and OK. After that, we have to set the motor on gear for rotation. Click the servo motor and specify the location of servo motor. After that, we have to go for profile details and give the angular velocity for rotation. Specify the coefficient in terms of degree per second. We have to specify 250 degree per second. Then click OK. After that, go for mechanism analysis. Click the mechanism analysis. We have to give the end time and a frame rate and count based upon your requirement. Just click run. After that, the motion is successfully created. Now the transmission systems is successfully rotated. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. If you're not subscribed in my channel, just click the subscribe and notification symbol. Inshallah, we will meet in next video.